2032. Mark that on your calendars, people, because we could be in store for a meteor shower that nobody really wants to see. And Earth is set to cross paths with something called the Taurid Swarm. But here's the thing. Every year, Earth passes through the Taurid meteor stream, and this stream contains the Taurid Swarm. Now, the Taurid stream gives us a pretty meteor shower almost every single year without fail, and that's often around September to November time. But in 2032, we might be in store for more than just sky sparkles. As we've said, the Taurid Swarm is part of the Taurid stream, and the swarm itself is packed with much larger debris, some big enough to do more damage than just a few broken windows. And so yeah, Earth doesn't typically pass through the swarm section of the stream, but in 2032, things are going to be different. Now, astronomers typically keep their eyes on two different things when it comes to keeping Earth safe and on standby: near-Earth objects, or NEOs, and comets. But the Taurid Swarm represents a different kind of danger. It's believed to be responsible for the famous Tunguska event in 1908, when 2,000 square kilometers of Siberian forest were flattened by what was likely an object from the Taurid Swarm. If that same comet would have exploded over a city instead of the Siberian forest, there would have likely been tens of thousands of deaths and countless millions of dollars in damages. This swarm could have also triggered a significant 1,000-year cold period around 11,000 BC, and possibly caused the Tagish Lake meteorite that fell in Canada in the year 2000. But hey, let's look at the worst outcome for us in 2032. A meteor from the Taurid Swarm will of course range in different sizes, but let's consider one around 50 meters in diameter, about the size of the Tunguska object. When such an object enters Earth's atmosphere, it travels at speeds of up to 30 kilometers a second, which is around 67,000 miles per hour. The resulting explosion would release an immense amount of energy. The Tunguska event released an estimated 10 to 15 megatons of TNT, which was enough to flatten those 2,000 square kilometers of forest. But if a similar sized object were to impact, say, New York City, the energy release could reach 15 megatons or more, which is about 1,000 times more powerful than the atomic bomb dropped on Hiroshima. The immediate area around the impact, roughly 10 to 15 kilometers in radius, would be completely obliterated. Skyscrapers, bridges, and infrastructure would be leveled by the blast instantly. The shockwave from the explosion would travel for miles, creating devastation well beyond the immediate impact zone. This shockwave would likely do the following: shatter windows as far as 50 kilometers or 30 miles from the impact point, cause extreme structural damage to buildings across Manhattan and even across the Hudson River into New Jersey. There would obviously be a massive loss of life and property, especially in the densely populated areas of inner New York City. Okay, these numbers and these predictions are pretty devastating, right? But how real of a danger is 2032 and the years surrounding that date? In 2019, a study by astronomers David Clark, Paul Weigert, and Peter Brown was published in the journal Monthly Notices of the Royal Astronomical Society, and it emphasized that Earth would encounter this cluster of meteoroids more frequently between 2022 and the early 2030s. The researchers pointed out that 2032 could be a year of particular concern, with some of these objects being large enough to pose an existential threat to Earth. Clark and his colleagues highlighted that objects within the Taurid Swarm could be harder to detect because of their faintness and high speed. The potential impact risks are not trivial, and the astronomers have already flagged this swarm as a potential hazard in the 2030s. While the probability of a catastrophic impact in 2032 is not definitively calculated, researchers are actively studying the swarm to better assess the risks involved. The detection efforts in 2019 using the Canada-France-Hawaii telescope aimed to quantify the density and size of the swarm's objects to better understand their threat. While the probability of a major impact remains relatively low, the Taurid Swarm's track record of producing large meteorites gives cause for attention. Some scientists estimate that the chance of Earth encountering a hazardous object during its pass through the Taurid Swarm in 2032 is higher than the typical background asteroid impact. However, a specific estimate on the probability is difficult to pinpoint due to the challenges in detecting and tracking such objects. So I guess all we can do is wait and find out what is going to come our way or not from now until 2032. And if you want to learn more about this wonderful planet that we inhabit, just click one of those videos on screen, and until next time, stay curious.